So in this video, our goal is to take what we've learned about the acid-base and speciation chemistry of amino acids and apply it to peptides. Okay, so what I have drawn here is just an example peptide that we're going to use in this video. Its sequence is alanine, glutamic acid, alanine, serine. And I'm also showing you a table that has some useful pKa values. And I'll note here that in this table, pKa1 always corresponds to the C terminus. pKa2 always corresponds to the N terminus. And then the third pKa, as the table says, is always the side chain. And not all of these amino acids have side chain pKas. And that's because not all of them are functional groups that can be protonated or deprotonated. So if they're not acids or bases, they don't have pKas. Okay, so I think what you'll find is that determining the, like, sort of going through the speciation for peptides is really similar to this, to doing it for amino acids. The only big difference is that you might have a couple more functional groups. But at the end of the day, the approach is really similar. Okay, so let's look at our representative peptide here. And to save ourselves a little bit of time and effort, what I'm going to do is suggest that we redraw this in an abbreviated, simplified form where we only worry about functional groups. Okay, so I'm going to abbreviate the backbone just as a solid line. So when I do this, I have this solid line where I have my N terminus, alanine side chain, glutamic acid side chain, alanine side chain, serine side chain, and now we finish up with the C terminus. Right, this is an easier way of drawing the peptide. And we ignore all the peptide backbone because, as we mentioned before, once the peptide bond forms, nothing is reactive. So in terms of the chemistry of the peptide, the only part of the peptide backbone that matters is the N terminus and the C terminus. Okay, so this is a nice way of writing out the peptide where we only focus in on functional groups. And in fact, in this case, I'm going to go even one step further and erase some of the side chains. The side chains that I'm going to erase are the ones that don't have pKas. So alanine does not have a side chain pKa. Serine does not have a side chain pKa, meaning that they are not going to be important in our acid-base speciation. So I'm going to go ahead and erase them so that we're not confused and bothered by writing them out. And what we see is we end up with a peptide that has three functional groups that participate in acid-base chemistry. We have the amine group at the N terminus. We have the side chain of glutamic acid. And we have the carboxylic acid at the C terminus of our peptide. So we have an H3X situation. And this is very manageable. So the very first thing that we want to do is we want to be able to predict what the charge of these things are under the in the fully protonated form. So remember, amines, when they're protonated, are NH3 and they have a positive charge, and carboxylic acids, when they're protonated in their acid form, they're neutral. So I need to redraw my amine here so that I have an NH3 with a positive charge. And what we see is the other two functional groups are carboxylic acids, so they're neutral. So in the fully protonated form, H3X, this peptide has a plus one charge, meaning that as we start losing protons, right? So we go from the H3X to the H2X. When I've done this, I've lost a hydrogen atom, and I've also lost a positive charge. So H2X is neutral. HX must be negative 1, and the fully deprotonated form is negative 2. So the next step is to write out what these things look like in these different forms and convince ourselves that we did it right. So we need to figure out what the pKas are for each of these individual functional groups. Glutamic acid side chain is the easy one. We find glutamic acid in our table. The pKa of the side chain is 4.07. So that functional group has a pKa of 4.07. To figure out the pKa of the amine term of the amino group at the N-terminus, we need to specifically choose the N-terminus of alanine. Alanine is our N-terminal amino acid, so this amine is attached to alanine. And alanine's N-terminus has a pKa of 9.87. And finally, the C-terminus is on serine, so serine's C-terminus has a pKa of 2.19. So our three pKas are 2.19, 4.07, and 9.87. The C-terminus has the most acidic pKa, so when we convert from the H3X to the H2X, we're going to deprotonate the C-terminus because it's the most acidic. So let's go ahead and redraw this peptide. In the H2X form. What we see here is that the side chain of glutamic acid is still protonated because it is not deprotonated yet. The amino group at the N-terminus is still protonated, but the C-terminus has been deprotonated. This now gives us a negative one charge at the C-terminus, a plus one charge at the N-terminus, and the side chain of glutamic acid is neutral, so the overall charge of zero makes sense. When we draw the HX form, the next proton that gets removed is the side chain of glutamic acid because it has the next most acidic pKa. So we draw this out. The N-terminus is still protonated. The C-terminus is still deprotonated. And now the side chain of glutamic acid is also deprotonated. So I have a negative one charge from the C-terminus, a plus one charge from the N-terminus, and a negative one charge on my side chain. So the charge of negative one overall makes sense. And finally, to redraw this for the fully deprotonated, we now deprotonate the amine. So now we have a negative one charge on the C-terminus, a negative one charge on the side chain, and the N-terminus is neutral. So the charge of negative two is accurate. All right, so our final step here is let's figure out what the isoelectric point is. Just like we saw with amino acids, we want to figure out which of these is neutral, and we've already done this. So we know that it's the H2X form of this is neutral. So if we average the two pKas that surround this, then that will give us the isoelectric point. So in this case, our two pKas are 2.19, the most acidic, right? So this transition is 2.19, and the next one is 4.07. We start most acidic and start working our way up. From H3 to H2 is 2.19. From H2 to HX is 4.07. So then the last transition would be the 9.87 for the N-terminus. Meaning that the pH where this molecule exists in 100% abundance is the average of 2.19 and 4.07. And this ends up being 3.13. Let's go ahead and try one more sample problem here. Lysine, aspartic acid, alanine. Let's choose glutamic acid. Okay, so we have four amino acids, which means we have an N-terminus and a C-terminus. And let's go ahead and draw this out using that shortcut that we've talked about before. We have an NH2. Our lysine is L-Y-S-I-N-E. Aspartic acid is the carboxylic acid. Alanine is a single methyl group. Glutamic acid is a carboxylic acid. And then we have our C-terminus. Okay, and I'm going to go ahead and take this one step further and draw everything protonated. Amines are NH3 when protonated, and they have a positive charge. Carboxylic acids are neutral, so they're neutral. So overall, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 functional groups that contain ionizable protons, and the overall charge is +2. 2 amines, 3 carboxylic acids. So when we convert to H4X, we have +1. H3X is our neutral form. H2X would be -1. HX is -2, so then X would be -3. Okay, and just to save time, I'm not gonna bother going through and drawing out the actual side chains for all of these different forms. But what we do want to do is to assign pKa values, because we need to know what this pKa is and what this pKa is so that we can average them. All right, so let's start with the C-terminus. So we have glutamic acid at the C-terminus. We want to get the C-terminal pKa for glutamic acid, which is 2.10. We also want the side chain pKa for glutamic acid, which is 4.07. We want the side chain pKa for aspartic acid, 3.9, and the side chain pKa for lysine, 10.54. And finally, we want to have the N-terminal pKa for lysine, so 9.06. Okay, so each of these pKa's correspond to a transition from one species to another. And we start with the most acidic and work our way to the most basic. The most acidic is 2.1. This corresponds to the C-terminus. The next is 3.9, which corresponds to the side chain of aspartic acid. Next we have 4.07, which corresponds to the side chain of glutamic acid. And then we have the N-terminus, 9.06, and finally the side chain of lysine, 10.54. So these are our 5 pKa's. And as we see here, the neutral form is between 3.9 and 4.07. So to figure out our pI, we average them. 3.9 plus 4.07 divided by 2. This ends up being 3.99. Okay, so this is the strategy for determining the pI for absolutely any peptide. We are going to consistently see amines and carboxylic acids, so please be familiar with them.